Hey guys, and welcome back to another Trains and World 2 video. Before we start, I want to give a shout out to James for supporting the channel. And today we're going to be taking a Thameslink service from East Croydon to Brighton. So this is a reskin for the class 377. I'm not too sure why they've used the 377 and not the 387, but anyways, it is what it is. I think this is a bit of an older reskin, so that's probably why. But yeah, it does come with the old school first couple of connect livery, which I'll show you in a minute. Yeah, here it is. Obviously, this is the old first couple of connect livery, but we've got the Thameslink logo on the side. Looking very nice. It does say 377 at the front, so I guess they probably should have got 387 instead, but anyways. I'm sure someone will make a reskin for this 387 at some point. Let's put the headlights on, which is over here. Right, before we depart, let me take a nice screenshot. Sounds a bit weird, as you can see. But yeah, I did make this custom starring myself, so we will be stopping at Gatwick Airport, Haywards Heath, Hassock, and Brighton. So driving the remaining part of the Thameslink service from Bedford. At least put a 387 at the front of the trains and a 377, so as the both trains look quite similar anyways, so that would have been nice. But anyways, I think we have to utilize what we have at the moment until Duffel Games add a Thameslink livery themselves. Just heard some announcements, so I did install this mod which adds custom announcements for the trains. So it's a bit low in terms of volume, so it's not perfect, but I guess we can see like how it works. I think it needs to be a bit more louder so we can actually hear them. I guess once we arrive at Gatwick Airport, then we can probably check carriages and see if you can hear it loud or something like that. Because maybe you can't hear it because the drivers can. I guess the ability to make reskins for this game isn't as easy, so some things like not working as they should do. I mean, someone did actually make a GWR reskin for the 387 for the GWR, of course, so that was actually really nice. You could just about hear those announcements. I think it said this is the southern service to, I guess, Brighton. These might have gathered between the train and the platforms. I believe they recorded all of these announcements themselves and tried to add it as a mod bar. Technically, this isn't a seven service, so it doesn't really make sense, but anyways. And then we're going to build airports. I'm not sure how to make those announcements louder. Maybe if we tweak some settings in the game, then that's possible, like, or something like that. Not too sure. Seven and a half miles till Köln Airport. I'm a bit tired, so I do apologize. Might be the 377 sound mod. I think I also downloaded that as well, so apparently it's meant to make the 377 sound a bit better, so that's probably why the horn sounds a little bit. Might need to disable that mod.
to Gilbert Airport, so we should be arriving at our first stop very soon.
Actually want us to stop for passengers, which is weird. Okay then, yes, we'll check continue. That's weird because surely if you add make customs now, you should add the option to like, you should stop for passengers, correct? I'm not too sure why it doesn't do that for when you make custom scenarios. Pretty annoying. I think the scenario made for this game is absolutely dreadful. At least it's good for this. But yeah, scenario maker should be making it like easier for people like myself who don't really know how to make scenarios. I mean, they keep making videos on how they're improving the scenario maker, but I see no difference at all with it. It looks like the same as it was when Trains and Locomotives 1 came out, in my opinion. I mean, you can't literally do it's pretty much like basic controls. I'm not too sure how people are making like really good scenarios, like some of the ones I've played before, so good to know. But yeah, they didn't even give me an option to add AI on the scenario either, so that's why there's no AI in this scenario, if you're wondering. Yeah, if someone does make a scenario with this train, then I will definitely play it, because it'll probably be a lot better than mine. Before that, AI and ability to stop the passengers, unlike this one, which is just being like stopped on the platforms, as you can see. Thank you.
it will see through soon. Well, my idea is just open the doors, just to pretend that we're dropping off passengers and then close the doors straight away. But yeah, I'm not too sure why. Give an option to like pick the passengers with a task very quick. That we have stopped at the station.
believe that line towards the left-hand side goes towards this one, I believe. Passenger view is pretty much the same. It's just the livery outside is different. Trains and Locomotives.
Now approaching Brighton on this train 7/8. To Brighton. Nicely done. Level 8 now for London Commuter. Yeah, that was a short Thameslink service from East Croydon to Brighton. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. If you did, give it a like, share with your friends, and I will see you in my next video. Bye guys.